You may never have heard the name Shi Meiyu, but she is one of the pillars of the faith that ministered in China over 100 years ago. Hey there, I'm Rebecca Carroll.
And I'm Jay Allen on the KCBI Morning Show.
And if I could choose one Bible verse to describe Shi Meiyu's life, it would be Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. And that says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your path. Shi Meiyu was born in 1873, the Qing Dynasty, which was the last imperial dynasty ruled over China. The major belief systems of the day were Confucianism, Taoism, and Buddhism. But Shi Meiyu was born into a Christian family. In fact, her dad was a Methodist pastor and her mom was the principal of a Methodist girls' school. Now, the culture was intensely patriarchal, it was communal, and it was honor-driven. Sons were prized over daughters, and scholarship and literacy were prized within the bureaucracy. Now, there's not a whole lot of information available about Shi's dad, but I would like to suggest that he had a passion for the Lord that made him very progressive for his time. Because even though Shi was born during an era where girls only learned the skills necessary to be wives and mothers, and if you wanted to find a husband for your daughter, you had to just about cripple her by binding her feet. Her father refused to bind her feet and encouraged her to go as far as she possibly could with her education. One person who really influenced Shi Meiyu was Gertrude Howe. She was an American missionary from Lansing, Michigan. And Howe took a bunch of girls, five young women, back to Michigan in 1892 to study at Michigan University. Two of them went on to become some of the first Chinese women to become medical doctors. One of them was Shi Meiyu. She joined the Women's Foreign Missionary Society and went back to Jiujiang as a medical missionary. She helped open a one-room hospital where they treated over 2,300 patients in the first 10 months and made hundreds of house calls. In 1901, she and a friend opened a 95-bed, 15-room hospital named after the wife of Dr. Isaac Newton Danforth, the Elizabeth Skelton Danforth Hospital. Now listen to this. Meiyu personally trained over 500 Chinese nurses and translated manuals and textbooks from English to Chinese. And as she trained them in nursing, she also trained them in the Bible. She went on to study at Johns Hopkins, came back, founded the Shanghai Bethel Mission. Her passion was to train nurse evangelists. And she is remembered as a powerful Chinese evangelist and was also the first Chinese woman to be ordained by the Chinese church in central China. And you know what set her apart? She trusted in Jesus. You never know where your life is going to take you when you trust in Jesus. But if you will trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding, you can move mountains for the Lord. The Lord will use you.
'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I proved you more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. I'm so glad I learned to trust him. Precious Jesus, Savior, friend. And I know that he is with me will be with me to the end. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove You more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I've proved Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Oh, for trust Him more.
Proverbs 3, 5 through 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your paths straight.
And that's why the Bible is the center of everything we do here at 90.9 KCBI.